dear colleagues. I'm here now for very brief concluding remarks to wrap up the discussion, wonderful, I believe, discussion we had in this 1.5 days. You know, I mean, honestly, I have mixed feelings at this stage. On the one hand, I'm very pleased with the discussion and with the level of event we had and so on, and also that actually a little bit sad that it didn't last so long, because basically, I mean, we could continue it for quite a long time. I think if we didn't stop a session with Professor Taylor, I think the Q&A session could continue for another 2-3 hours and so on. Just right now, we had a very wonderful discussion, which was, I would say, still could continue for quite a time. On the other side, I would say, for me and especially for my colleagues from the Central Bank who have been contributing to the organization of that event, they need some rest now, definitely. And I mean, they probably are looking forward to a weekend with a nice weather in Kyiv and so on. So it's good. I mean, there are good events, but it's good also that they finish. And and I think here, I mean, you know, I think that definitely was a very good discussion. There's a lot of actually to digest. Yeah? And we would have a video broadcast, and that would be, you could then look at it back and look at the presentation and so on. Because, yeah, we have learned a lot of things. So we learned on a credit registry in Bosnia. So we learned about national champions in Sweden. And I think those who are nostalgic about Saab cars understand that they have no chance, because Riksbank would not finance the renewal of the production of Saab cars. We also actually learned that the secular stagnation is not so secular, yeah, that stagnation traps probably exist, and the demographic factor is actually quite important for the monetary policy, especially in the longer run. But what I would say is actually interesting that, you know, the many participants in the excellent presentations yesterday and today argued that the central bank should adjust their behavior according to the new normality, and which could be characterized by slower economic growth, probably even due to this lack in aggregate demand, lower equilibrium interest rates, due to the demographic trends, higher probability to get to the deflation or stagnation trap. And consequently, many alternatives were proposed to the central bank in these circumstances. On the other side, I mean, no one from our prominent speakers actually rejected that the price stability should be out as the main priority for the central bank. Yes, it could be complemented by financial stability, we just have heard, and so on. But inflation remains a monetary phenomenon, and the authorities responsible for money creation should continue to care about the value of money. Of course, and the sound banking sector is also an important other dimension. And I would say, myself and my colleagues in the board, to some extent, we feel vindicated that the conference once again supported our vision that building the modern and independent central bank aimed at achieving and maintaining price stability and financial stability should ensure valuable contribution of the central bank into sustainable growth and bring prosperity to the country. Of course, I mean, the job doesn't stop there, and job doesn't stop only in kind of in there within the central bank, because the independent central bank could only survive in the kind of, I would say, reformed country where structural reforms are really done. And I mean, definitely Ukraine needs a prudent fiscal policy, structural reforms to boost productivity, streamline public sector services, anti-corruption efforts, and so on. And the central bank, the National Bank of Ukraine, is standing ready to support other government authorities in their efforts in reaching these objectives without jeopardizing its own functions. At the end, I also would like to reflect, you know, I was so pleased at this conference to see so many young faces in the audience. BA students, MA students, young researchers, and so on. Because I think that's a conference actually for the next generations as well. Yeah? To see the level of economic discussion and where we should go and so on. Because for us, since the central banks are institutions which are managing expectations, yeah, it's good to manage expectations of clever people who understand what the central bank is doing. So, and I'm extremely pleased to have a so good discussion here, and also extremely grateful to participants and speakers of our conference who, apart from conference, have been participated in public discussions and giving lectures to the university and talking to the Ukrainian media. And last, definitely but not least, I would like to thank for all speakers for excellent presentations and speeches. and also to all the participants for attention and contributions with the questions to this impressive discussion, and definitely also to the organizers, to our colleagues and partners from Narodowy Bank Polska, from Kyiv School of Economics, Government of Canada, and definitely to the employees of the Central Bank who helped to make this event happen. And also at the end, the special thing, you know, I mean, I regularly got the question during these two discussions, I mean, how it's possible to get people like John Taylor or last year Maurice Obstfeld to Ukraine? I mean, how it was possible? You see, I mean, it's very difficult. You should be a friend of Yuri Gornichenko to achieve it. Because, yeah, I would like to thank Yuri specifically, but also actually to our good friend Oleksiy Krivtsov from Bank of Canada, who unfortunately could not come. Who, I mean, both Yura and Oleksiy, they really helped a lot in designing the program and helping us to lure to Kyiv such good speakers and so on. So, and definitely, I mean, you know, it's a second conference, and I'm feeling now that I have no chance not to organize a third one. Yeah? So, and probably not tomorrow, but on Monday, I should start to think about that. So, thank you, and hope to see you next year.